We are creating or laying the foundations of some long-term problems of, you know, the perception of BC being not a welcoming province for its visitor economy.
BC's tourism industry leaders are not impressed with the potential of an interprovincial travel ban, which Premier John Horgan says he's now exploring with legal advisors.
This is a public interest, and we have been trying our best to find a way to meet that objective of the public in a way that's consistent with the charter and other fundamental rights here in Canada.
Vivek Sharma with the Tourism Industry Association of BC wants him to stop pursuing it. He'd rather see the government work with the tourism industry to change visitor behavior instead of considering a travel ban.
Travel is not the root cause of the problem. You know, how can we help in influencing people's behavior who are coming to BC, and by imposing things like travel ban and creating animosities between different, you know, communities or people living in different communities?
In a press release, a coalition of tourism industry leaders say a travel ban would further cripple a sector that is barely hanging on by a thread. The coalition's legal advice says it will be difficult to implement a travel ban because it could infringe on the mobility rights of Canadians, which are enshrined in the Charter of Rights and Freedoms.
When you look at the Canadian Constitution, the ability of citizens to move across provinces is one of the foundations and fundamentals.
But one constitutional law expert says the government of BC will probably be able to justify a ban, even if the charter provides mobility rights between territories and provinces.
The constitutional structure still allows for the government to justify that rights infringement, and that's under a provision of the Charter called Section 1. And I think there's a convincing argument in the times of the pandemic, with the numbers that we're seeing elsewhere in Canada relative to what we're seeing in BC, that the government has lots of sound justifications available to give to the courts.
Even if BC banned interprovincial travel, Sharma questions if such a thing could really be enforced. BC isn't like the Atlantic provinces, who were able to make a bubble because of their fewer entry points.
But when you look at British Columbia's border, it's so vast. We have so many entry and exit points, and there is such a huge workforce of people who live in one province and work in the other province, you know. How are all of those things going to be managed?
BC's premier is now discussing provincial borders with his cabinet, and we'll have an update next week. In Vancouver, Kyrgyz Nos, City News.